Hello everyone. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about the Executive Development Program in the HRM. So first of all, I would like to tell you about what do you mean by executive development. Executive development, or also known as management development programs in the organizations. So executive development or management development is a systematic process of developing knowledge, skills, attitudes, and insights of managerial personnel to manage the work and people effectively. So it is basically how we are going to develop the employees in our organization as far as their knowledge is concerned, their skills are concerned, and overall their attitudes and their managerial persona gets developed. As we have written in the definition also, that executive development focuses on developing in a systematic manner the knowledge base, attitudes, basic skills, interpersonal skills, and technical skills of managerial cadre. So here, we are basically working towards the interpersonal skill, means the communication skills of the people, the overall behavioral skills of the managers, technical skills, the knowledge base, and the attitudes. So in all, we can say that it is the overall personality development of an individual which will enhance his level of working in the organization. Executive development programs basically deals or focuses on the employee's personal growth. That is why I use the word personality development, because it focuses on the personal growth. The employee will grow personally. It is like helping a person to learn about his personal strength and weaknesses. Many a time, the new employees enter an organization, they don't know their own capabilities or the potential they possess. So it helps, the organization helps in learning that particular person actually learns about what potential is hidden in him. What are the basic areas of his strength and weaknesses? It ensures greater job satisfaction, because when you are having a better personality, when you have developed yourself, you feel good in doing your work also. So we can say that management development or executive development is basically concerned with improving the manager's performance in their present roles, as well as preparing them for the greater responsibilities in the future. Then comes the components of the executive development program. When we design these, the HR department basically has the responsibility of designing these programs in the organization. So there are basically three components how we design the programs. First is management education. It is acquisition of a broad range of conceptual knowledge and skills in formal classroom situations in degree granting institutions. So basically like the courses like MBA, PG diploma in business management and all. So that kind of management education is needed, because in those management education programs, you get to know the basic concepts of working in an organization. Then comes the second part, that is management training. So it basically deals with providing specific skills or knowledge that could be immediately applied by the employees within an organization or to a specific position within an organization. So training basically, as we all know, is related to imparting or learning specific skills. Those skills which are needed for you in your present role and responsibility in the organization, or for the future roles and responsibilities that you might get. So that management training is needed. Then third comes, which is an important role here in the executive development programs, is the on-the-job experiences. These basically are the planned or unplanned opportunities for the managers to gain. Through these opportunities, managers basically gain knowledge enhance their existing skills or information within the context of day-to-day activities. Like, I give you certain examples, like when the managers are mentoring their juniors, or when they are coaching their juniors, or when they are assigning tasks to their juniors, they learn by these things also. They learn while teaching others, we learn a lot. So through these on-job experiences also, you get to learn so many things. You get to learn so many skills, your behavioral aspects, your leadership qualities, your motivational qualities. And these are the basic components of the executive development programs. The next topic in executive development program is its importance in the organization. So see, these executive development programs are important for the organization as well as individually for the employees also. It is important for the employees because it increases their various skills. As we have already seen, the basic aim of imparting these programs or having these programs in the organization is to impart or to give skills to the employees. Second part is complex nature of the executive job. See, the work of a manager or the management's job is very complex in nature. Complex in the sense it is not as straight as you can see. There are so many dynamics being involved here. There are so many complex or open-ended, fragmented things keep coming on. So how you are going to deal with such dynamic nature of your job? That is why you need to have a good persona. You need to have a calm and quiet mind to assess the things nicely, the problems that are coming your way, and to find the solutions to those problems. Then it helps to deal with the problems of change. As we know, change is something which is the most inevitable in nature. But having said that, despite we knowing that change is inevitable, we fear change and we always resist to change. So by going through these executive developmental programs, we learn how to deal with the change. Organizations and their environments are very dynamic. See, business environment, economic environment, these are very dynamic in nature. And considering the nature of the economy and nature of the business now as a global economy and global business, the changes have become more dynamic. So if you are adamant towards your job, towards your responsibilities, towards your behavior, you might not be able to survive in this thing. So it helps you in dealing with the problems of change, or it helps you in accepting the change in a better way. Then executive development programs also helps you to contribute to the business success. Yes, it really helps. It contributes to the success of the business by helping the organization to grow the managers. It requires to meet its future and present needs. It improves the manager's performance because, see, we are trying to let our managers grow, to give growth to them by having good knowledge, by having good personality, behavioral skills and all. So in such a way, if you are having good managers in the organization, obviously your business is going to be a good success, a great success, I can say. Then comes better results. So management development programs helps improve the quality of management, as we have seen in the previous points, which explains the difference in the price policy, production policy, marketing policy, all the different policies that are being made in the organizations. Thus, the better the management, better are the results of the organization. We can just say, or we can just summarize the importance of executive development program by the simple thing that better the management, better are the results. So these executive development programs are very, very important, both for the development of the employees as well as for the organizations. The next topic that we are going to cover here is, now what is the process of these executive development programs? How do we basically design these programs? So for defining these programs, the first step is looking at the organization's objectives. What do we really need to achieve? What are we looking forward for? What are the standards that we need to get? So first of all, we'll look at the organization's objectives or analyze the objectives of the organization, and then analysis of the needs. Analysis of needs means the future needs for managers. What are the qualities or what are the qualifications that we need in the managers for the future? So we need to analyze those things, that what are the skills? Do they need any kind of training? Do they need any kind of other developmental activities that we need to analyze? Then is appraisal of the present managerial talent. A qualitative assessment of the existing executives is made to determine the current management resources. So we basically, what we do is an inventory of the executive manpower is prepared. Thus, the data on age, qualification, experience, performance appraisal results is collected, and then an analysis is made of this information. And then we basically, what we do is then we analyze or appraise the present managerial talent, that these are the things that we are having right now. So we are basically, so now we have two things, that we have a data about what are the future needs, that what are the future skills that we need in our managers. And in the third point, we have got the data regarding what are the present skills that our managerial talent has. Now in the fourth point, what we'll do is ascertaining the developmental activities so that we can fill the gap between point number 2 and 3. Now we'll design the activities, because we have that what are the future things that we need. We know what are the present situation that we are in. Now we need to fill this gap. And to fill that particular gap, we do or we plan the developmental activities. Then what we do is, in the next point is determining the individual development needs. So the next step is, in this step, what we do is skill development, changing the attitudes and knowledge acquisition. See, what the companies expect is that most of the management development programs will center on changing the attitudes and acquisition of knowledge. The basic aim of these programs is that the overall personality development happens. So that is why we need to find out in every individual manager of our company that what are the areas, of their weakness, of their personality. And we need to have a, what we can say is like a custom-made program for each of the individuals. Then comes designing training and development programs. So designing is, once we know the developmental needs, it is necessary to assess those types of development programs that can meet these needs. हमें needs पता चल गई हैं, अब हम उसके हिसाब से अपना developmental program बनाएंगे. Training and development program we'll be designing according to that. And then we'll impart and we'll let all our managers enroll into that program and complete the program. And then we'll do the evaluating the programs. Finally, once the managers have engaged in these developmental activity, we'll evaluate. We'll look for the changes in the behavior and the managerial performance. We can fully appraise a program's effectiveness and highlight its weaknesses. We should develop information that will aid us in determining whether the development should be continued or how it can be improved. Evaluating is done just for knowing that, was our program a success? Then objectives that we have set at the beginning of the program, do we have achieved them or not? So basically, all this assessment is done with the help of observation, means we observe the behavior of the managers. Is there any change in their behavior or not? Interviews can be taken. Their productivity and cost records can be maintained. So by all these programs, we can evaluate the, by all these things, we can evaluate the effectiveness of the executive development program. So this is the process of how we design and how we impart the executive development activities in the organization. The next topic that we are going to cover is the methods. What are the different methods of management development programs? These methods or techniques are also used for training purposes, because basically through these programs we are training our employees to be better individuals and better with better personality. So some of these points we have already discussed in the previous lectures also, but then also I'll explain you all these things. So the first method of executive development program is understudies. Understudies, in this method what we do is that the trainee works directly with the senior manager. See, every time for every individual in an organization or for every employee in the organization, there is always a senior. So the understudy relieves the executive of certain responsibility. So what we do is we'll delegate some of the responsibilities of that senior person to our junior executive, so that we can assess that how well is he able to perform the duties of the senior executive. So the understudy relieves the executive of certain responsibilities, giving the trainee a chance to learn the job. So basically the superior allows his understudy. Understudy is a person who is like a subordinate person, to discuss problems with him and to participate in decision-making process. So this is how you're basically learning how to take care of the responsibilities at the higher level, how to discuss those problems, and how to find out the solutions to the problems. Then is systematic rotation. In systematic rotation, what we do is the trainee is rotated periodically from one job to another. Thus, that person acquires a general background of various jobs and positions. In a planned rotation program, the job switches are made in periods of about 6 months to a year. The aim of this method is to broaden the knowledge, skills, and the outlook of methods. This method is often used with junior managers in the companies so that they can learn the different aspects of management, how the work is being conducted or done in different areas. So this is like their training program itself. Third is committee assignments. Committees are regularly constituted in the organizations. So in these, committees are assigned objectives and responsibilities related to the works, and they also have competent personnel. Now, through discussions in these committee meetings, trainee managers will get knowledge about different viewpoints and solutions. So committee assignments could very well provide the necessary general background of various management issues. So through committee assignments, when you're working in a committee, you are part of the meetings of those committees, and you learn about the different nookhouses of those departments and the working of the management. Next method is special project assignments. In this method, what we do is a number of trainee managers are given a special project to complete. Now, this project may be directly related to the trainee's functional areas. The group will study the problem and find the appropriate solution. For example, some junior managers working in finance section may be assigned the project of developing an effective control system. By working on this project, what will happen is that the trainees will learn the different working procedures and techniques of cost control. So basically, what we are trying to do is that by putting you in a situation, we are trying to make you learn by being in that particular. This is like simulation. You are actually in that situation and you're trying to learn the things. So this is highly useful and flexible training method, and these assignments ordinarily grow out of an individual analysis of weaknesses. Here we also get to know the weaknesses of many of the people, because it's like a group assignment. So when many of the people are working together, we get to know who is having what kind of qualities. somebody will have good leadership qualities, somebody might be having like weaknesses of working under people. So those behavioral things can also be learned through these changes, through these assignments. Then next is the multiple management programs. In this program, a junior board of young managers is established. We establish a junior board, like the board of directors in the company, we establish a junior board. And then major problems are analyzed in the junior board and recommendations are made to the board of directors. So these young managers will learn. What they'll learn is how to make decisions and to create the collective wisdom, like how to reach at a consensus. And then what they'll do is then they'll put up the recommendations to the board of directors. So in that way, they are learning about the different aspects of management. Then the next process or the next method here is transactional analysis. Transactional analysis basically is a method, is a behavioral scientist have found this method to understand the behavior of ourselves. It is like do-it-yourself method. It is seriously, it is based on the concept of improving the interpersonal relationships. You have to understand your own self, that where your ego comes into play, where your self comes into play, and where you are so giving in nature. So in this transactional analysis, understanding the three ego states possessed by all, and then analyzing the interpersonal transactions, how we basically deal with different kinds of people. Through these transactional analysis, we basically try to find out about ourselves, that we behave with certain people with very much humility. We behave with others with very egoistic nature. We behave with others with very carefree nature. So we need to understand why our behavior changes with people. So that is about the transactional analysis. It helps us in knowing and improving our behavior. Then the last method in executive development is behavioral modeling. Behavior modeling basically is a method to develop and teach interpersonal, manual, cognitive, and supervisory skills. This method is based on the basic idea that we learn by observing others. So as we say behavior modeling, we have to make somebody our model, role model. And by making, in this process, what we do is we ascertain somebody as our role model. We watch them either through live, we are watching them, or by their videos or something, we watch them. And then we try to understand what are the areas that really impresses me so much about him. Like, I give you an example. Personally, I'm a big fan, or we can say I'm a big admirer of Swami Vivekananda. I admire him like anything. So he is like a role model for me. So what I need to do is, if I am into this program, that I'll watch his videos, I'll read his work about him, and then I'll analyze what are the aspects of Swamiji's behavior that really inspire me. And then that things I'll try to retain with me. And then I'll try to behave in such a manner. I'll try to adopt Swamiji's behavior, which really I think that, wow, this is something that really made everybody, the whole world, Swami Vivekananda's fan. So that is behavior modeling. You have to make somebody your role model, analyze his behavior, what are the positive aspects of his behavior, and also negative aspects if there are any. Because negative aspects are also very important, so that you can take it into consideration that I should not be doing this. I should not be behaving in this way. I should not be, my body language should not be like this. So that behavior modeling is also one of the important aspects of executive development program. So this is all about executive development, students. So we have studied here about the concept of executive development, then the basic components, that is management education, management training, and the on-job experiences. This is how we basically do executive development. Then the importance, why is it necessary? the process, how we do it, and basically the methods, how we do executive development in the organizations. So this is all about executive development part of the unit 4 of your syllabus of BBA part 2 of HRM. So I hope the concept is clear to all the students, and thank you very much. Thank you all the students.